that Jesus had prepared for her. And while for us it is, yes, a day of grief, it's also a day of hope. Because Jesus paid the penalty for Carrie's sins, he has now welcomed her into her heavenly home. And Jesus provides all of us with that same hope. He doesn't give up on imperfect people. We're no worse than St. Peter. I mean, think about it. Peter walks on water. And then he takes his eyes away from Jesus and starts to sink. Peter says, I will never deny you. And he denies Jesus three times. In Galatians chapter 1, we find out that Paul had to take Peter to task because he messed up again. We're no worse than Peter, no better than Peter. We're no worse than Carrie, no better than Carrie. We're all in the same boat. We're sinners. But Jesus died for sinners. He doesn't give up on us. He doesn't go, he did that again? Jesus died for all people, paying for all sins. And that includes you and your sins. Your sins are gone in Christ. Believe that Jesus is your Savior. Trust in his promise of everlasting life. And you have hope forever. It is going to be difficult for all of us to think of life without Carrie, because for all of you, she's always been there. She was maybe younger, but she was always there. And yet in Christ, we will see her again in heavenly glory, because our Savior, Christ Jesus, abolish eternal death and gives instead everlasting life. Jesus was Carrie's hope, and she has not been disappointed. When Jesus is your hope, you will not be disappointed either, but you will live forever in heavenly glory. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus unto life everlasting. Amen. We join together in hymn number 727.
Thank you.
January 14, 1921, to Jacob and Christina Howe from in Spring Valley Township, Dickey County, North Dakota. She grew up in Tender Road School and Edgeley Public School in Edgeley, North Dakota. Carrie married William Conrad and they farmed near Monangle, North Dakota. Later, she moved to Edgeley and worked at the coffee shop. She married Richard Bernhagen and worked at Edgeley grocery store until retirement. She moved to Manor St. Joseph in 2006. She was a member of the Land Lutheran Church in Edgeley. Carrie is survived by one daughter, Caroline Conrad of Fargo, North Dakota, two grandsons, Terry Barber of Alco, Nevada, and Kim Barber and his wife Dawn of Sundown, Nevada, one son-in-law, Darwin Barber of Hardin, Montana, three great-grandchildren, four great-great-grandchildren, and many nieces, nephews, and their families. Carrie was preceded in death by her parents, two husbands, one daughter, Betty Brower, eight brothers, Fred, Jake, Ivan, Ronald, Mullen, Johnny Wilbur, and Albert Trum, and six sisters, Rosina Strum in infancy, Pauline Paul, Frida Heller, Irene Geisler, Adeline Hartman, and Violet Wintershire. Carrie departed this life on Friday, April 9, 2021, at a hospice house in Fargo, North Dakota. She attained the age of 100 years, 2 months, and 27 days. May we cherish her memory. May God comfort those who survive. We rise for prayer. God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We pray together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.